welcome back to the 2015 Parade of Lights. Look at that little light snow.
It's gorgeous, Michael.
Michael Engle here with my co-host, Paula McPheeters. Welcome from Pueblo Community College, the Center for New Media, bringing you this wonderful broadcast. And, of course, we have a third member of this broadcast, and that's Aaron Hergert. Aaron, you out there?
I'm out here.
All right. Boy, I see the beginning of this wonderful 2015 Parade of Lights. Paula, you have said that Santa's coming.
That's what I've heard, Michael, and believe me, there's a lot of kids out here excitedly waiting for Santa Claus.
Oh, yeah. Gosh, let me mention again, I mentioned in the opening, but the Center for New Media bringing you this wonderful broadcast. They've had a heck of a day out there.
That's right. They were at the East High School football playoff game today, where East was victorious, and they're out here tonight filming a parade.
Yeah.
All in a day's work.
You just saw the wonderful patrol cars here from the Pueblo Police Department who are really kind of leading this, and we're so proud of our law enforcement. And, of course, you can't have a parade without an honor guard. And
that's we got, right.
And who is part of this honor guard?
We've got the Pueblo County Sheriff's Office as well as the Pueblo Police Department represented here tonight.
Yeah, which was so nice. They just came and said, hey, by the way, the police department that's is joining right. in on this. And, gosh, we are so proud of our law enforcement.
That's right.
We know that it's some crazy things happening in our community at various times, but Pueblo Police Department, Pueblo Sheriff, representing us very well.
That's right.
Oh, and look at the lights up on the uniform there, hat.
They are ready for the holidays as well.
And hey, that's
sure,
neat.
We sure appreciate their sacrifices and just everything that they do for us in our community.
Indeed, indeed. Oh, and this is so nice. Paula, if you'll see, the crowd is standing up for the presentation of the colors here.
Yes.
Again, our honor guard opening up the 2015 Parade of Lights, the 26th annual.
Isn't that amazing?
It's incredible.
It's a Pueblo tradition, and whether the weather is warm or whether it's cold, people show up, and it's an amazing event.
Well, of course, here we have our grand parade marshals, and I think it's the Gladneys.
Carrie and Karen Gladney. Carrie was one of the original founders of the Parade of Lights 26 years ago when he was president of the Pueblo Downtown Association. Carrie's also served on the board of directors for the Downtown Association and has been a judge for entries for most of the years of the parade. And she's been active in Crime Stoppers. South High School Junior ROTC is carrying the banner for them. And we are so excited to see them decked out with their hats and their decorations for this parade.
And then, of course, followed by the Pueblo Downtown Association. This is the past and present board members and family. It's being driven by Dan Holmes. That's a 1935 Graham Brothers half-ton steak bed truck.
That's beautiful.
Yeah. And, of course, for the Downtown Lottery Association, the Colorado Lottery and their lottery attire is coming down the road here.
There you see the Powerball. Isn't that interesting? All dressed up. It's our signature sponsor for this parade.
Yeah.
And they're having a great time.
Yeah.
Checking out.
I'm a little envious. I'm thinking some of those guys got to be warm out there.
I was going to say, I think I'd trade right now for one of those Powerball outfits. Keep rolling.
Again, the Downtown Association, that's one of their signature sponsors, the Colorado Lottery.
That's right.
So glad to have them with us here. Well, you've been promising, Paula.
I told you Santa was on his way, and our next event we're going to see here is the Pueblo Convention Center, home of heroes.
Oh, let's hear a little music with
that's
them.
Right. And there he is.
The one and only Santa Claus.
The man of the season. Hey, Santa.
Hey, Santa's waving at us.
That's right.
Oh, he just pointed to us.
I told you I've been good all year, Michael.
Well, I hope so. I have a Christmas wish for Scott Richards to get some new camera equipment.
Okay.
I know he's got a big, long wish list of some new HD cameras. So, Scott, we're going to let Santa know about that.
Well, next we have Agape Fellowship with the beautiful float reminding us of the reason for the season. The church has a nativity scene that we're seeing. And I even see, it looks like a few of the expected entries you would see in a nativity scene. The three kings are on that float as well.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Wow, kids that's... on that float.
Oh, it looks like they're all bundled up, though. Nice to have one of our local homes of worship here celebrating with the Parade of Lights.
And let's just say, they really know how to celebrate the season. It's really great to see,
they do.
Michael.
They do. And if you'll notice, that snow's picking up a little bit out there, but it's not going to deter them. Aaron Hergerd, are you out there?
I am out here enjoying the crowd. How are you guys doing?
Doing good. Who's that young man with you there?
Well, this man here, his name is Grant, and I just wanted to come up to him and say hello. How do you think of the parade's going so far?
It's going great. I'm seeing a lot of Christian floats, which is making me happy.
Tis the season, right? Look, here comes some more, guys.
All right.
Back to you.
The Quarter Midget Racing Club. This is the Southern Colorado Quarter Midget Racing Association.
That's right, and it's for kids ages 5 to 15 years old, and it's at the Pueblo Motorsports Park, and they have a lot of fun doing that.
Yeah. Gosh, it wouldn't be a parade without a fire truck. The Pueblo Firefighter Historical Society, educating the Pueblo on the great history of the Pueblo Fire Department.
And let's just say that's a classic automobile. We're seeing that fire departments now, it's amazing to see those anymore today because they're classics.
That's true. And, of course, we go from the antique to the more modern here.
That's right. American Medical Response is the next in our parade. They're patient-focused, customer-centered, caregiver-inspired, and it's an ambulance decorated like Rudolph pulling a sleigh.
Yeah, very nice. AMR has been a proud part of this community for many, many years.
That's right.
Oh, you know, now you're a Pueblo native. Are you a Bulldog?
I am proud to say I'm a Pueblo South High School alum.
You're a Colt.
I'm a Colt. But I am in the parade, love all schools. Centennial is an awesome representation as well, as you have a daughter.
Yes,
that goes to
matter
Centennial.
Of fact, she's in the cheer and dance squad here, and they're performing their holiday routine. So Pueblo Centennial High School proudly representing here tonight. Oh, and all the girls are lit up
tonight.
They
are lit up. That's some Bulldog pride right there.
Indeed. Well, at least the movement's keeping them warm.
I was going to say they're a lot warmer than you and I are sitting here.
Speaking of that, I think we registered around 24 degrees at the beginning of our broadcast. So, of course, these girls work for hours and hours. All of the dance teams at our local high schools, they work a lot of hours.
That's right. There's a lot of time and effort that goes into these parades, and we appreciate everybody that is, even though it's cold and it's snowing, they came, and we're enjoying all the hard work they put into this parade.
Indeed.
Of course, it wouldn't be a parade of lights without electricity, right, Michael?
That's right, Xcel Energy, one of our proud utility partners here in the city of Pueblo.
And I'm not sure what character is on that float, but he looks like a big honey bear.
Yeah. Oh, it looks like we still got actually. Oh, looks. I'm sorry, I think we got ahead of ourselves here. This is still the Bulldogs with their pride. Oh, they are really coming out tonight.
Oh, sorry about that. That is Centennial.
Oh, there's the Bulldog himself.
And they have a really festive float here with all kinds of characters.
Yeah. You know, we hear a lot of things about our young people, but boy, when you come down to these events, you see a lot of great students doing some great things. Xcel Energy, now here's Xcel Energy.
It wouldn't be a parade without electricity,
There you go.
And we're lighting it up in downtown Pueblo with this parade.
Glad to have them with us this evening.
And they have a live singing event on their float, which is pretty cool.
There's the Pueblo. Well, let's see here. We got some members out. This is Lonnie Lopez. Mission for great Christmas spirit in a car that's decorated with reindeer, lights, cartoon characters, and lighted presents.
And if I'm not mistaken, that's a minion on the back of that one. AIM Healthcare is our next entry. And you can see they've got some really cool automobiles.
All right. AIM strives to provide superior health care to patients through dedication and passion in work. Their decorations will have banners and balloons and lights and a DJ. So AIM Home Health Care, Avita in Integrative Medicine, and AIM Diagnostics.
That's right. And next on our parade route, we've got the Nutcracker Ballet with the Sangre de Cristo Arts and Conference Center. And, of course, the Nutcracker is one of their most sought-after events of the season. So we're glad they're part of our parade. And they're a nonprofit organization whose mission is to serve as a valuable community resource, providing educational opportunity, quality visual performing arts, and artistic venue for celebrations.
Wow. And you can look at these young ladies out here.
Just a little sampling of what you'll see in the Nutcracker performances they do. Beautiful.
That's wonderful. Again, this broadcast is brought to you from Pueblo Community College, proud sponsor of the Parade of Lights, this 26th annual Parade of Lights. What do we have here, Paula?
Pueblo Academy of Arts Marching Phoenix Regiment.
Under the direction of Mr. Lyman Bushovsky, proudly presents Pueblo Academy Arts, a school that approaches education through the integration of the arts into every subject. Okay. Again, that's Pueblo Academy of Arts. Believes that all students can achieve excellence. There's more of the Rising Phoenix or Marching Phoenix Regiment here.
And they're lit up for the season as well. I notice they've got some lights on the drums and...
I think we're at St. Joseph's Parish now. St. Joseph's Church committed to following Christ in faith and love. Diverse community of believers who are committed to following Christ in faith and love through the sacramental tradition of the Catholic Church.
Great contributors to our community, and we love to see these kind of entries into our parades.
And here's a bus bringing some more individuals with the St. Joseph's Parish.
That's right, and they've got it all decked out and lit up.
Stop here for just a moment. Wow, that bus is lit up from St. Joseph's.
They're lit up and ready for the parade.
There we go.
Christmas greetings from St. Joseph's Parish.
Merry Christmas. Oh, that's nice. And throughout the parade, we'll be checking in with Erin Hergert. She's been out there checking out folks in the crowd. So yep. Be sure to let us know, Erin, when you're ready to visit with someone.
She's our lady on the street, roving, looking for those who are happy to interview with us. Our next entry is Angelo's Pizza.
Yeah. Gosh, because we're right next door to Angelo's Pizza.
And that's some fabulous pizza, I'll say.
Well, and of course, as their logo says, their size matters.
That's right.
So. Of course, Angelo's, a great institution here. Because again, we're right next door to them as we're sitting here.
That's right. And they got a giant snowman on that float.
Yeah. It's a big truck.
It's a big truck and big pizza.
Got some sound to go with it. Followed by the Miss Pueblo County Scholarship Pageant is a long-running organization that gives young ladies in Pueblo a chance of completing their education goals by earning a scholarship for college and also being a positive role model for the community.
That's right, and we hope the mission of Miss Pueblo County Scholarship Program is to empower them to dream, hope, believe and inspire. And Michael, we hope they eventually want to come to Pueblo Community College.
Absolutely. We'd love to have them there. Again, we're gearing up right now for spring 2016.
That's right. If you're looking for a place to come to school, PCC is the place.
Oh, now look at these beautiful young ladies here. Again, some more folks from the Miss Pueblo County Scholarship Pageant.
And they look at they've got their wave on. They know how to do the wave.
Let's go out to see Erin Hergert.
It's such an honor to be out here with the crowd. Everybody's really enjoying the parade, and I came upon this wonderful lady here. How long have you been out here?
About an hour and a half.
Has it been hard sitting here watching the parade, waiting for it to start?
Yeah, it was.
What do you think of the parade so far?
It's very nice. I like all the colors.
Well worth the wait.
Perfect.
Well worth the wait.
Oh, definitely.
Awesome. Enjoy the parade.
And it is worth the wait. Thanks, Erin. It is worth the wait. We've waited for a while to see this spectacular display out here.
That's right. We just saw the Pueblo County Sheriff's
office
go by. And now we've got the West Park Fire Department coming up. And now we've got Dolores Huerta.
Yeah, this is the Chavez Huerta K-12 Preparatory Academy.
And they've got their bus decked out as well with lights and all kinds of people inside the bus. Now, they're actually pretty warm in there, I would think,
Michael. Oh, I would imagine so. Chavez Huerta, their mission is to provide a well-rounded student education, through a rigorous college preparatory environment, which does culminate in a high school diploma and tuition-free college credits. And of course, we are proud partners at Pueblo Community College with Cesar Chavez and Dolores Huerta.
That's right.
Wonderful partners.
We have a lot of students that go both to PCC and Dolores Huerta, and it's great to have that.
They're like a lot of the schools here, Paula. They're well represented. This is an additional part of this float. Wow, they have really decked this out.
They did. That's a lot of work into a float for a parade this size.
Yeah.
And that's the fun part of a parade, is you get to see people that are excited to watch and excited to participate.
Oh, look, yeah, again, look at these wonderful students out here representing Chavez and Huerta K-12 Preparatory Academy. Looks like they have some of their dancers with us.
They got their spirit team here and their cheerleaders. There they are. And they're having a great time at this parade.
Oh, gosh. Now, look who's coming up down the road here.
Who is it?
I think that's the South High Student Council
Cult Nation.
I'm going to let you run with this one.
Well, you know, I don't want to show my bias as a South Cult alum, but, you know, the student body cheer and dance team, when they come down, it's a little hard for me not to get too excited.
Again, another great representation from a great Pueblo school. It's great to see these young students out here.
That's right. I have a feeling it's going to get pretty loud.
Yeah, the South Colts, they know how to put a party on.
Yes, they do.
You know, we've done so many football games at Dutch Clark, and South High always has great school spirit.
Yeah.
Look at that trailer rocking there.
I'm not sure the axles will hold that trailer very much longer.
That's Colt Nation representing Colt Nation.
Well, we heard him here tonight. And here we have the Pueblo Ice Arena Figure Skating Club.
Yeah.
Is that right?
Celebrating its 40th anniversary and is sponsoring a second float with the Pueblo Figure Skating Club. The theme is Toyland as they get ready for the club's holiday show, December 13th.
Another great event in Pueblo for you to come out and see.
Yeah, 40th anniversary of the Pueblo Ice Arena. Great Pueblo institution, right, Paula?
That's right, and we do have a lot of hockey players in Pueblo. Youth hockey is very popular here, so it's a great opportunity. If you don't have your kids into anything, look at hockey.
Yeah, there you go. And this is a perfect hockey night, is it not?
Oh, man, it's like being on the ice, Michael.
Ah. Again, I want to remind our viewers, this is a production of the Center for New Media at Pueblo Community College, and we're so glad to have this broadcast available via Comcast Channel 19. And you'll be able to see this parade throughout the holiday season.
That's right.
Scott Richards and Lauren Montoya leading our broadcast crew tonight. And I'm going to mention a couple of other names as we go along this evening, just a kind of a shout out, if you will. Colorado Parks and Wildlife evening.
And we see some representation there of wildlife on that float.
Yeah.
And the other things we like to do in Pueblo, we've got the reservoir. You see the wear your life jacket with the speedboat there. It's hard to think about being in the water right now, Michael.
I know. I'm sure there's some diehards out there, though. Little Kings. Little Kings youth basketball team. It's a nonprofit. Their mission is to give young athletes a chance to play competitive youth basketball year-round. Little Kings. Glad to have them with us tonight.
They got the hoops lit up for us, Michael. They got it all decorated.
Yeah.
Next, we have the Roncalli STEM Academy Marching Band. And I can hear them, and as they're coming up.
Gosh, this is their marching bag, their flag team, their palms, their mascot. They love to represent our school. There's their mascot.
He looks pretty warm to me.
Yeah, yeah. Again, there's one of those envious things.
I know it.
Gonna get very proud seeing these young people out here.
Yes, it's always.
We hear so many negative things, but about, you know, youth and our community, but you wouldn't see it from here, would you?
No, this is the best of Pueblo, and it's exciting to see.
Give them a listen.
They're playing his song.
Yeah.
You got the flag team. And on a cold night like tonight, that is a hard job.
Yes. Again, if you're joining us, welcome to the 2015 Parade of Lights, downtown Pueblo, Colorado. Michael Engle and Paula McPheeters from Pueblo Community College. Glad you decided to join us. The 26th annual.
It's amazing.
Here's the Rye Fire Protection District.
Now, this is a truck of trucks. If you're talking about wildfires and you're talking about protecting a community, they have the vehicle to do it. This is an amazing piece of hardware that they have, and so glad they took time to come be in the parade.
Indeed, of course, in their terrain they frequently are involved in, up near Rye. Rye just got nearly a foot of snow in the few days.
Next up, we have Miller's Coors RMC Distributing Company.
Yeah, our family at RMC is the local Miller and Coors distributor. They'd like to wish everyone and their family a safe and happy holiday, and do remind everyone to drink responsibly. I mentioned to you earlier, it's the broadcast from Center for New Media. I mentioned Scott Richard, Lauren Montoya, Danny Medina, Andy Sandville, Ryan Cameron, Brian Mose Hill, and I'll get to some more names, but these are all part of our broadcast crew. Almost all of these people have been doing broadcasting since early this morning at Dutch Clark there.
That's right. Right now, we're looking at the Playtime's Over Car Club. The PTO Car Club supports kids for holidays, and the Car Club banner leading 60 cars with visual effects, as we can see. They've got these cars decorated well.
Wow, that's neat.
And, of course, the Colorado State Fair Fiesta Committee, if we could think about that already in December. We're not even in December, and we're thinking of the Fiesta Day Parade.
The committee is dedicated to promoting and celebrating the Hispanic culture while providing educational opportunities and scholarships for young Hispanic students. The 2015 Fiesta Queen, Rebecca Suazo. First attendant, Selena Martinez. Second attendant, Rosas Ramos. And third attendant, Ariana Gonzalez, representing Pueblo right here, the 2015. Followed by the Avondale Vineland Lions Club.
Wow. They're a charter club affiliated with the Lions International and focused on prevention and treatment of blindness, diabetes, and major causes of blindness. The Lions Club projects include eye exams and glasses to needy kids in the community, screening vision exams, and this float displays the mission of the Lions to address these issues.
That's wonderful. Glad to have them here. Sangre de Cristo Hospice and Palliative Care. They're here to enhance the quality of life and to maintain the integrity of individuals and their families who are unfortunately facing end-of-life opportunities.
That's right. Pueblo's unique in that we have such a great support system for those needs in our community. And we see a float celebrating life.
That's pretty cool.
And what do I see next, Michael?
Oh, my gosh. I see the Panther. It's Pueblo Community College, the STEM Club.
That's right. Pueblo Community College Panther, the STEM Club.
Followed by the PCC Student Life. A lot of our wonderful students here at PCC out here having lots of fun. Look at them.
Pueblo Community College lighting it up out in the parade. Of course, we're always proud of our student body and the effort they put into not just the production of this event, but just representing Pueblo Community College so well. And we just appreciate the work of our students, faculty, and staff always.
Indeed. There's some additional folks there. Look, there's someone there from our fire science program,
I
believe.
There you go. A lot of work goes into those floats and a lot of lights.
Yes.
Now we've got Pueblo County High School, and I think we can see the top of that. There's some pride on that float as well.
Yeah. There's our wonderful mascot.
Pueblo County High School is well known in our community with lots of alumni, and we're always so happy to see the school spirit for every school that's represented in our parades.
Oh, and here's some of their dancers and their Palmers and cheer squad following up on that float.
I'll tell you one thing, you wouldn't know it's cold out here by watching them do
their
thing.
No, now we might be cold here, and our wonderful camera crew out here. I mentioned a few more, Fred Carrillo, Lee Tron, Josh Weaver, Zach Koshkop, Zach Gutierrez, Kiana Montoya, Gus Johnson. I'll get to a few more here, but.
We've got the Pueblo Rural Fire District. And again, they've got their fire truck lit up with Christmas lights. It's so great to see.
This is a 1945, is that right? Yes. Seagraves fire truck. And they have a hazmat response vehicle as well, I think, coming down the road here. Let's go to our lady on the street, Erin Herger. What do you got out there?
Hey, I just happened onto Becky Cortez and her son, AJ.
Oh, wow.
So you guys have been in this parade before, haven't you?
We have for several years, yeah.
Several years. What's it like putting together a float?
It's a lot of work. It's a ton of work. We didn't get it done this year, but it's a good time.
Good time. You enjoying the parade?
We are. We're loving it. It's fun to come watch.
Good to see you, Becky. Thanks.
Okay.
Back to you guys.
Hey, give Becky our best. We're glad to see
her
out there.
I will.
This is awesome.
Next, we have the Pueblo School for Arts and Sciences. And we can see they've got a big rig coming up here.
Yeah, they provide an integrated K-8 curriculum based upon, are anchored in arts and sciences for the success of all students. This entry highlights the talents of PSAS, their marching band, and their color guard.
That's right.
Oh, they're going to ride and play. How neat. They got the right idea.
That's my idea of marching band.
Yeah.
Again, you see the commitment of the students and the faculty to put things together, and we just appreciate that they're a part of the parade today. Next, we have Racine's Locksmithing and Security. Obviously, they provide a lot of services in our community, and again, we're happy to see them out demonstrating what they do, which is locksmithing, security, medical alert, and security cameras. If you've ever locked your keys out of your car, you know what a valuable service they provide.
It's one of those services you don't think about until you need them.
Until you need it.
Yeah, so looks like they got a couple of their trucks out here. Glad to have Racine's with us. Again, while we got a little break here, want to mention again a couple of our additional crew members here, Duncan Richards, Ian Richards, and Nate Richards, all part of the Richards clan there, who always pile on and help out during one of our broadcasts, and Danny Medina, who does our audio and makes things really happen for us, and I don't want to forget our good buddy Kevin Millis back in control, or master control, who is always making sure that what you see on all of our community access channels happens. So, Kevin, thank you for your great work back there at the studio. We're thinking about you as you're sitting there having a warm cup of coffee.
It's a team effort for sure.
Yeah.
Next, we have Vineland Middle School. And again, it's an organization that is student-led and develops leadership skills, which we love to see. And engineering is one of their focuses as well. They love to showcase programs offered at Vineland and have a lot of Christmas lights and theme decorations on their float. And just take it all in as they're coming by. They've put a lot of effort and time. And
I think we're going to see their dance team as well, the VMS dance team.
They're right behind them.
Yeah, there they go. Those young ladies coming out this evening.
They had Santa's sleigh as their float.
Gosh, this is something that's near and dear to my heart. Paws for Life. It's the animal welfare group dedicated to rescuing and finding homes for lost, abandoned cats and dogs. There's no place like home, frolicking in the grass and trees for Paws for Life. Looks like they got some of the pups out here. Let's go to Aaron Herger. What do you got, Aaron?
Hey, I got two handsome guys, Isaiah and Manuel. Hey, guys, how's it going?
Good.
What's your favorite part of this parade so far?
Where Santa is on the bus.
On the bus? And yours?
Same thing, where Santa is on the bus.
Have you guys been good this year?
Yes.
Are you going to get lots of presents?
Yes.
Awesome. Thanks for talking. Enjoy the parade, okay? Back to you guys.
Thanks, Aaron. They had something in common with me, and it was Santa. Next on the parade, we see the Pueblo Child Advocacy Center.
It's a nonprofit with a mission to prevent child abuse. And the float is decorated with a gingerbread house for a family-like setting with the reindeer lights and the snowman. So we're sure glad they're here. And the Pueblo Municipal Court is here.
That's right. And we see a lot of folks out representing this organization, and they do graffiti removal and lots of things in our community to improve the quality of life here. So we're glad to see them out as well.
Yeah, there's some of the young folks there. Again, the snow, we got some flurries out here that continue to fall. And the Heroes Academy cheer is here. Their colors are green and gold. And the girls are performing a dance routine for this parade. Hopefully we get to see it, maybe not.
Maybe we missed it, I'm not sure.
They might be taking a break from it. Again, here's some of the, not gonna miss it.
They're behind them.
Yeah,
there they are. There's the cheer squad.
The cheerleaders, yeah.
They got their Santa hats on. Definitely exhibiting the spirit of the season.
Indeed. We're kind of shivering out here. Good Times Cruisers. A street rod club. Right here from Pueblo.
You know, Pueblo likes their street rods.
I was saying, we got a lot of great street rod organizations here.
That's right. And that's a classic right there on the float.
That is.
And of course, it wouldn't be a parade without a Big R float.
Yeah.
And here we see the lit up Big R coming by.
You know, a lot of people don't know Big R began as a family owned business. And now it's one of the largest farm, ranch, and home retail stores. They have 24 stores, over 600 employees, still growing. So what they have is Rudolph, and they got cowboys and cowgirls.
I love it. And in the spring, they have baby chicks. Have you ever been there?
Oh, yes. It's a family tradition. My daughter and I go there.
Very tempting, but I never get one.
Oh, you just got to go and look.
I just look.
Yeah, yeah.
Now we have the Rain or Shine Home Brew Supply Company coming up.
If you want to learn how to make home brew beer and wine, you need premium ingredients and equipment in stock, and they have it in stock. 542 Brew. That's an easy number. 542 Brew. Here's their slogan: see the burn, hear the boil, smell the aroma, taste the brew. Hey, you know, as the guys in the camera crew would say, you had me at taste the beer.
Yeah, and you know, it's steaming off of their float right now, so.
Yeah, all right. So Home Brew Supplies, 542 Brew. Glad they came out tonight. Now, gosh, this is the Pueblo Derby Devil Dolls. Oh. Roller Derby League. Women on flat track, they're a competitive roller derby league. And proudly representing Pueblo, Colorado. These young ladies, boy, if you've ever watched any of that, that is competitive.
They're tough. They take it serious.
Yeah, they don't play around, do they?
No, that's why I watch and don't play.
you don't want to join the Devil Dolls today?
No.
Sears. Sears of Pueblo?
Sears of Pueblo bringing the sleigh. Sears has always been a strong supporter of our military with our Heroes at Home program, with 100% of all their donations going to the families of our military.
Oh, nice. And of course, we are the home of heroes, so
that's
it's
right.
Nice to have Sears support that notion as well.
We love our veterans. We love what they have done for our country. We love when they come back to our communities and become part of everything that we do.
Indeed.
Next, we have the Relay for Life, the American Cancer Society Relay for Life event. We love to see them in our floats. They remind us of why it's so important to be involved, and the American Cancer Society does that through many different fundraisers. What they have tonight is a Mustang driven with lights.
Very nice. Pueblo Pups and Hounds 4-H Club. Their mission, of course, is to teach youth valuable life skills and responsibilities through practical application of 4-H projects in an environment that promotes strong relationships between individuals, friends, and family. Oh, and look at those dogs.
There are some cuties on that float. Now we've got the Knights of Columbus. The Knights of Columbus is a Catholic fraternal service organization donating countless hours.
You know what? I'm sorry, Paul. I think we got one out of order there. They skipped one. It's Walmart.
Oh,
instead.
Walmart. Okay.
Yeah,
sorry about that. We've got Walmart.
Their mission is to be a store of the community and spread joy, winter wonderland, Santa's workshop with elves, building toys, light and music. This is a mini version of Walmart.
Okay, and after that, we've got the Abundant Life Ministries Praise Dance Team coming for us. And they've got a van, and I'm thinking that the Praise Dance Team is just behind this.
Yeah, they're a non-denomination, Christ-filled ministry. Their goal is to strengthen marriages, single adults, youth, elderly, through Christ's word.
You know, throughout the parade, we were told there were some entries that didn't make it tonight.
That's true.
Our apologies if we get things out of order, but there's been a few changes in the schedule, and we're going to adjust.
Again, you're watching a production of the Center for New Media at Pueblo Community College. It's the 2015 Parade of Lights. If you just joined us, you don't need to come down. You can see it all right here.
Matt Bissell, this is just a personal entry. Somebody took the time to put together a really nice trike bike, is what I call them.
Yeah.
It's a three-wheeler. I could drive that.
Yeah, that's pretty cool. I love the antlers on there. Now, check this out. This is the Hip Hop Factory, Miss Dre's Dance Emporium. They offer hip hop dance, school of dance. This is Pueblo's only hip hop dance studio.
Hip hop dance, bringing it down. And look at them having fun out here. Oh, Lou, what do we got next?
Oh, my gosh. You know what? That cannon there has to be on. There's Tuffy from East High School.
East High School.
Fresh off of a semifinal win tonight.
That's right. Congratulations, East High School.
East High School going to defend their state 3A championship. And, of course, Center for New Media, you can watch that game right here on Channel 19.
And right behind them, we have their support system, their cheerleaders, their student body. They're pretty excited about that win today.
Wow, that's pretty cool.
It's an exciting thing for Pueblo whenever we see a football team make it to the level that they've made it.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. We're so proud of the East Eagles. The Eagles' nest is rocking tonight, that's for sure. Oh, my gosh, the Kelly Clowns unit of Alkali Shriners, group of Shriner Clowns. Their mission, of course, is to assist in supporting the work of Shriners International and their network of 22 hospitals for children. And of course, it would not be a parade without the Shriners.
That's right. You gotta see the Shriners.
Southern Colorado Nephrology Association also here. Saving Kidneys, working hard. Glad to have them with us tonight.
Yeah. Next.
Here we go. Go ahead.
We've had East, we've had South, we've had County.
And now
we need Central High School. Big Blue coming down the street.
they're really emphasizing their STEM Academy curriculum this year, and they're really making some things happen over at Central High.
Again, you see a lot of school spirit coming down the street. And if I'm not mistaken, that's the bell that rings blue.
It does indeed. You had to remind some folks. I'm sure there's some listeners or viewers that are pleased and others are not.
Well, in Pueblo, we like to share these things, whether it's the cannon or the bell.
There you go. That's
it goes back and forth. Again, you see a lot of school spirit represented here tonight, as well as the Central Wildcat. I believe I just saw him go by.
Yeah.
Mascot. And I wonder where our friend Miss Erin Hergert is. Is she out and about? Is she ready to tell us what's going on in her world?
Erin, you out there?
I am out here.
We just want to say hi to you.
You know, the crowds are actually, you know, people are getting cold. I know. The end's getting near, but we're still sticking in here. It's an awesome parade, isn't it?
I love the
high school floats. They're just amazing, aren't they?
Oh, it's
amazing.
Wonderful. Interim Healthcare of Pueblo just came through. They're a home healthcare agency, and glad to have them with us tonight.
And they've got a really nice representation with this truck. Loaded with people wishing you happy holidays and home for the holidays.
The title of their float is Home for the Holidays. So they just want to represent a nice home. They got a little hearth there going.
Yeah.
So, Erin, you mentioned it was cold. It's 24 degrees out here. And I can proudly tell you the temperature hasn't dropped since we've been here. It's been a steady 24 degrees.
It hasn't gone up and it's not dropped.
Oh. You know, after a while, you just kind of go numb.
That's right.
Doesn't matter. It's all good.
Yeah. And again, I feel bad whining because these camera guys and camera ladies have been out at working these cameras since early this morning. And they've done a stellar job. They're out here. It doesn't matter if it's raining or snowing. They're out here. Erin, go ahead.
Well, we got a couple that have been out here waiting this whole entire time. You guys aren't going anywhere, are you? You're going to wait till the end?
Probably, yes.
Awesome. How about you? Are you enjoying it?
Yeah, of course.
Do you guys come out every year?
Mostly, yeah.
Every year?
Yeah, this is my son's a senior, and this is our last year to kind of come out together and watch the Parade of Lights, so we decided to do that.
Memories, right?
Memories, that's right.
That's what the holidays are about.
What a great family tradition.
Guys. Back to you.
Thanks, Erin. Columbia Elementary Student Council. Today's students and tomorrow's leader.
That's right.
They model their Thunderbolt Pride. Hey, that's neat. This is a rendition of what they call a midnight snow, and it seems like we're in a midnight snow here.
They picked the right theme for this year, didn't they?
Yeah.
And we've got the home of Lowe's Home Improvement, and they say never stop improving.
There you go.
And we try to support that at my house.
Indeed. Lowe's, of course, a great community partner here in Pueblo. Glad to have them join us this evening.
And it looks like they had the Grinch on the back of that float.
Oh, goodness. We don't want that.
I see a float that has...
Oh, this must be our Pueblo County Commissioners. Is that possible? Trying to figure out a number here.
We've got a Pueblo County Commissioners float, and we've got a Pueblo Chili sign on the side. And Sal Pace is on that float, as well as a lot of other Pueblo County.
Glad they came
employees.
Out tonight. And, of course, you folks saw the new Pueblo Chili certified, our new advertising campaign there to support that. Not sure if this is our low and slow float.
Yes, low and
slow.
Yeah,
the low and slow car club of Pueblo. Having fun and enjoying the community and family for holidays. Low and slow. There you go. Check my footwork.
They always have amazing entries.
Oh, they do. Now look at this here. Look at these incredible vehicles.
A lot of work goes into that, too.
Ryan Cameron, our camera guy directly in front of us, always does a great job of shooting some great scenes there.
Little happy face.
Yeah.
I believe this is the Pueblo County Republican Party.
Okay.
That just went by on the back.
Yeah, Republican Party. On the road to Christmas.
And is this Betty's costumes?
Well,
what is this?
I'm not sure.
Or they're advertising Betty's costumes. I don't know.
Yeah, I think we're Betty's costumes here. Sorry, folks, we're trying to keep up with it, but sometimes the entries are going by pretty quick, and they're missing some of their numbers or identifying tags here.
I thought you could read minds.
Sometimes I can. Now look at these old, beautiful cars.
Beautiful. Classic. And you see these not very often, but in parades, so it's really a neat thing to see. Candy Creations is what they're called.
Oh, Candy Creations. Okay.
A lot of time and effort in those vehicles.
Indeed. It's always nice to see little kids out there. And
boy, they got it figured out, though. They're in the car. Yeah, they're not sitting out here watching.
CDOT, of course. And boy, CDOT, Colorado Department of Transportation. They help you get where you need to go safely. Rain, snow, or shine, there are no breaks for CDOT. And look at this monstrosity here.
That is a snowplow of snowplows.
I guess. Many times they're the first to arrive when your car breaks down or there's an incident on the highway. And, of course, their mission is to provide the best multimodal transportation system for Colorado. So, and we really think a lot about CDOT this time of year.
That's right.
As they say, folks, give them a break here.
That's right. They do a lot of work in weather that we wouldn't want to have to
drive
in.
That's right.
And we appreciate it.
And they get us where we need to be. So thanks, or hats off to CDOT.
That's right.
Now here's Betty's costumes.
Okay.
Yeah. Established 1971 by Betty Hegler. She's now retired. She's passed the business on to her grandson, Salvatore Howes, who's also owns the Smooth Carriers Moving Company. And their new location is 103 North Union. So they still, same kind of service. You can still rent all your costumes there, dancewear. And of course, they have a seamstress on hand there as well.
And this is the La Gente
Bombers football. That was a classic song we love.
That's right.
When you hear that, you can't help but sing along.
Next, we have Legacy Homes of Pueblo. Of course, they build homes all over Pueblo County, and this float represents...
It's a life-size gingerbread house.
Wow. Excitement is building in Southern Colorado with quality floor plans starting at the 230s. I think if I had a house built, that would be a pretty good one to build, don't you think?
Yeah, it would.
Next, we have the Azteca Softball Club.
Yeah, head coach Ken Ramos, assistant Matt Sanchez and Dick White, Don Nunez and Kenny Chavez. They're 18 under, placed second at USSA World Series in Joplin, Missouri.
Wow.
Which brought over 25 more girls to that program.
That's great.
Yeah, this is awesome. Gosh, Paula, I think we're wrapping this up tonight.
We are. It's been a great parade.
The 2015 Parade of Lights, the 26th year of this. Where's our compadre, Aaron Herger? We want to thank you for your great service tonight.
Thanks, Michael. You guys did a great job with the parade. Thanks to Pueblo Community College for helping sponsor it. And thanks to all the people at Center for New Media for braving the cold and all that they do for the East High School game today. You make us proud at Pueblo Community College. I just want to let you all know. So it's been a great evening, huh?
Oh, that's awesome.
It's been awesome.
We have to be right there with you. This fantastic crew here, Paula, the Center for New Media, not only put this event on, but again, we talked about it. They've been
over
at Dutch Clark all day. And look on Channel 19, folks, bigger things happening. That's right. On behalf of my co-host here at Paula McPheeters, Michael Engle, the Center for New Media, Aaron Herger, and the entire Pueblo Community College family, and especially Dr. Patty Urjavec, president of Pueblo Community College, we want to wish you a wonderful holiday season.
And a Merry Christmas.
We'll see you next time, folks.
Bye-bye.